Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In the last video, you saw some examples of how exponential functions can be used to take an initial amount and multiply it over and over. But sometimes we don't actually have a definite end goal in mind. In this video, we're going to learn how to set up exponential functions that can be used to predict these amounts at any value we choose. The objective for this video is that, at the end of this lesson, you will be able to write exponential functions for real-world problems and real-world scenarios. Our tasks for this lesson are to first learn the difference between exponential expressions and exponential functions, then you'll watch two examples worked out for you, and finally you'll get the chance to try an example yourself and find out how you did. Remember the form for exponential expressions: the initial value times some growth factor raised to some power. In any situation, the same initial value and growth factor can be used to find the resulting amount at any point. In these cases, we make the exponent an independent variable so that we can easily substitute any value we want for it. This also makes graphing exponential situations easier. Your post goes viral on social media. On the day you posted it, it only got shared 14 times, but that number quadruples every day after. You may be thinking to yourself, aren't we missing something? We know the initial amount of shares and we know how fast it's growing, but what day do we want to predict? Well, that's the thing. We're not looking for a specific day here. By just leaving the X there, this becomes a function that can be used to find the number of shares on any day. If we want to know how viral it was by the third day, we plug in 3 for X. For the number of shares after a week, we just plug in 7. You get the point. The best part about exponential functions, though, is that you can graph them and estimate values at a glance. You'll learn how to graph exponential functions later in this unit. Your city's population grows by 15% every 3 years. In 2015, the city was home to approximately 230,000 residents. What are the important pieces of information here? Well, it's important to know the initial value as well as the growth factor. Since this growth factor is a percentage, we do need to be careful. Do you remember how we used a percentage in the last video? Since the amount is growing by 15%, we first use a factor of 1 so that we can keep the previous amount plus 1/15. So a growth rate of 15% means our function's growth factor is 1.15. There is one more super important piece of information here. That 15% is applied every 3 years, not every single year. So we can't just count the number of years. We have to split it into chunks of 3 years. Think of it this way. If we want to know the population in 2018, that would be 3 years after 2015, which means the 15% would only be applied once. If instead we wanted to calculate the population in 2028, that's 13 years past 2015. So the 15% would be applied 4 1/3 times. That divided by 3 keeps the 15% occurring every 3 years rather than every year. So now we've got our function for the population any year after 2015. Starting at 230,000 people, it grows by 15% every 3 years. And again, we can graph this function to see the exponential growth. Do you think you could write an exponential function on your own? Pause the video and try this example. In the beginning of this scenario, there were 120 bears in the park. Then, that amount grew by 9%, the whole previous amount plus 9/100 of it, for a growth factor of 1.09. But that growth wasn't over a year, it was over 2 years. The function representing the bear population in this park is 120 times 1.09 to the x halves power. And here's what that graph looks like. Now you can write a function for any exponential situation. In the next video, we'll have to interpret given exponential functions to understand the scenarios they describe. See you then.